What's up, everybody? You're probably wondering why I'm up here talking and it's not Myron and Cortland. Well, that's because I have something special for all you hot spotters. The past few weeks, I've been talking about my upcoming mixtape entitled Rise Above All, and a week ago, I released a song entitled Savage. Well, that song finally has a visual treatment to go with it. So with that being said, check out the premiere of my first music video, Savage. Nilly Nation, hope you enjoy. Roll it.
This for the dream chasers, for the ones determinated. This is for the trendsetters, for the ones that's motivated. This for the go-getters, ones who trying to make a statement, and the ones that's working hard. This ain't for no suckers hating. This is for the college kids with goals of graduation. This is for the dropouts who still trying to make it. Know that I put on for the people who put on for themselves. Shout out to the people hustling, I don't do this for my help. I just kick flows, no knapsack. Got a flow to lead on my snapback. What I tell the haters to back, cause I'm too focused to backtrack. Before my time like a flashback. Now I'm asking where the cash at, and you'll never find where my stash at. So don't bother checking my backpack, nope. Don't be looking at me for no handout. Tough times got you sitting in, well it got me standing out. And like Mike Jack said, no, I gotta beat it. All I do is win, so I never get defeated. Screaming in the nation till y'all repeat it. Permanent market flow can't be deleted, cause I'm de-trending topic. Allergic to nonsense. My hustle can't knock it, my vision can't stop it. Ben Frank's in my wallet, it's taller than ostrich. I gotta make a profit like it's my only option. Cause
my goal in life is not to lose and be a winner, but I got the shot to win it. I just need to pull the trigger, but my confidence is high, cause my team needs me to deliver. And I'm in this thing to win it, and I'll never be a quitter. So paint a vivid picture, let you see the image, cause I'm just getting started. So just imagine my finish. My flow is sweet like Splendor, so you could say I'm splendid, but I had to eat my spinach. It's survival of the fittest, and I'm not your average Joe. Don't got an average flow, don't got an average sister, don't got an average bro. When I perform, I'm not the one to have an average show, cause I'm far from average, so never the status quo. See, average is a failing, classes is a daily habit, so I'm bending over backward to make sure I'm more than passing. But the average person might say passing fancy satisfaction, so I kindly have to ask them why settle for being passive. What you call a problem, I say I'm about to solve it. What you call a masterpiece, call it getting started. Yeah, you say that I'm lucky, I just say that I'm thriving. Yeah, you say that I made it, I just call it surviving. And I am not one in the same, breathing so I can't complain. Fly as a plane, now the neighbors know my name. Like my first name is Jermaine. Dang, I'm having a hard time adjusting the fame. Coming fast as a train, throw off the chain. Lyrics I spit is insane, rise above all is the set that I claim. If bands can make a dance, and Beyonce a dance for me, then best believe I throw off the rock with a Yankee cap on just like Jay-Z. Yeah, you said I got no swag, then clearly you misguided. Cause I've been fly for so long, I'm on autopilot. Raining or it's sunny, my lyrics sweet as honey. Them numbers looking funny, gotta re-up on some money. So I add it up, then multiply, then gotta do the subtraction. And never ever will I divide, cause I don't deal with no fractions. See, it's hard to talk and take action, I'm too for real to be acting. And if you're playing games, I leave you hanging like Dwight Howard did the magic. See, I never did no crime, but I'm jaywalking no traffic. With them Concords and them Bread 11s, Olympic 7s and Raptors, yeah. They always told me what goes around comes back around. Then why my deal ain't come, cause my flow was one of the nicest. They even told me what goes up must come down, but they didn't tell me they excluded out the gas prices. So I read between the lines just to focus on the grind, cause if you ain't looking forward, then you getting left behind. And alienation is the click that I call, and if you don't remember nothing, remember Rise Above All. Swerve.
There you have it, folks, the premiere of Nilly's video, Savage. But before we get to that and ask them a few more questions, I would like to welcome each and every one of you to the Hot Spot. I'm Myron Smothers.
And I'm Cortland Johnson. Now, Chanel, we got a few questions for you, but I will say I enjoyed the video.
Well, thank you.
But I didn't get no call or nothing about this video shoot. I got all black clothes. I'd have been good.
So basically, you upset you couldn't be a video girl. They all dream. She watched that BET movie with Megan Good, but hey, it'd be like that sometimes, but hey. I didn't get an invite either, so why are you complaining?
Well, but you're not me.
Well, first of all, you did get an invite, but you didn't respond to a text message.
See?
So that's a little shade on your side. And second of all, I'll get you on the next video.
See, right, AT&T is... Okay, so, yeah, maybe that's my fault. I did get an invite, but ha, you didn't. Poor Cortland.
Can you stick to the script?
It is on the script.
Well, I guess I'll forgive Nelly this time. But let's get down to it. people you see, you know, see you as the go-to guy for music on the hotspot. But, you know, this is the first real glimpse of Nelly, the rapper. So let's talk about that. When did you start rapping?
Well, I started rapping when my basketball team needed a warm-up video, a warm-up song. So I was always known as a person who would be rapping all the songs. I was always that annoying kid rapping everything on the radio.
And we know you. Anyway,
Yeah, so they asked me to do a warm-up song, so I contributed to a warm-up song, which led to another warm-up song for the girls' soccer team, which led to my first mixtape, my second mixtape, and now we're here now.
Started from the bottom, now you're here. No?
Corlin, you and me. I'm sorry. Corlin, you just got to stop. Okay, so we know you are a rapper, and we know you love Kendrick Lamar. We hear it probably every week on the show. But besides Kendrick Lamar, who is somebody you consider like a role model in the rap game for you?
Well, I would have to go with J. Cole. I mean, his whole delivery, how he attacks the beat, his whole talking about him struggling, and all of his sports references. I mean, he has the total package from the wordplay to the storytelling to the sales to match with it, and I just look up to him and I try to emulate him in my style.
Okay, so back to this video. How did all this come together? All black clothes, the bridge stuff. How you thought all that?
Well, to be honest, I can't take full credit for the video. I really can't take half of the credit for the video. It was a lot of ideas brought to various people, ranging from my roommates to my friends to my family to other people with outside opinions. But basically, I wanted to have. The song is really all over the place, but it has an aggressive tone to it. Mm-hmm. So when I named it Savage, it was me and actually one of my friends, Shellen, that named it Savage. And I kind of thought of like not a gang, but like a group, like Nelly Nation, like a group of people rallying around me. So that's what the all black thing was and the group of people.
Shout out to the light skinned people. We saw y'all make a little appearance. Y'all on the come up. But as you can see, audience, you didn't say a single curse word in the video, and no, ladies and gentlemen, that was not the clean version. Chanel here doesn't use curse words in his music. Can you touch on that a little bit?
Well, I just figured there's a void in the music game right now, well, in the rap game right now. I feel like there's a lot of people who feel like you need certain language, certain explicit material in order to carry your point across, but everybody has a wide vocabulary, so you can use certain words that aren't as necessarily explicit material. So my thing is I want to come as hard as a person with explicit lyrics, but I want to still contribute a positive message.
Okay.
I respect that. So Rise Above All is the name of the mixtape. When can we get that and what should we expect from it?
Well, the official date for Rise Above All to drop on DatPiff is April 29th, but since y'all know y'all my family, you can actually go get it on DatPiff today. Right now, if you want to.
Exclusive.
The title, Rise Above All, on DatPiff.com.
Okay, and you know, I heard most of it already. It's dope, and my favorite track is the one I'm featured on, you know. I'm on the track, you know, spitting the hot. I'm not rapping, you know, but I talk at the beginning. So make sure y'all check out Yodo and all the rest of the songs.
Wait,
it's
hold
gonna
on.
Be awesome.
I'm not featured, and I didn't get a call for the video shoot. Nelly, we done. We include them all.
Sorry.
And this is the time where Chanel should have been like, commercial break.
Welcome back to the hotspot, everyone. For those who missed the premiere of Chanel's first music video, go to YouTube and search Nelly Savage and it'll pop right up.
Well, Corlin, I gotta take off the jacket because it's about to get hot in here. Another artist recently dropped a video. Marlon talked about this song a few weeks ago. Thirst level is rising, but let's just stop the talking and just watch the body party. Sierra finally released the visuals to her single Body Party.
Can you talk right, please? We know you thirsty, but you sound real parched.
She hating because she couldn't do all them acrobatics.
No,
because anyway.
My stomach would have started hurting.
But why are y'all flying through the script? I don't know. But hey, Courtland, the video has been getting great reviews, and I bet. Flew to number one on the iTunes charts.
Probably because a little thirsty boys like you, Marlon, and Chanel. Yeah, Chanel, you too.
See, Nelly, you don't want to get on this one's bad side. You should have put it in the video. You should have told about the song, mixtape or something, because she's going to throw shade for days now.
Throwing trees.
But honestly, Courtland, when the video dropped, I actually saw more women commenting and showing the admiration than men, you know?
I'm not surprised. The video was nice. Ciara, I'm not saying I'm wrong. When Myron put in the script, he wants me to say, Ciara always drops these videos that make you want to learn a trick or two, but I don't feel that way. I'm not learning no tricks, baby.
So you ain't try to learn how to ride the beat when she dropped that ride video?
Didn't I just tell you my stomach would have started hurting if I did that?
So you weren't trying to make a few promises when promise video dropped?
That's easy. See, I could do that. That one was cool. But all that stuff, that's like
it's
doing
not
crunches.
The same. But Courtland, what do you have for us today? What's popping in the news, in the entertainment news?
Well, Myron, before we talk to Marlon, I must say we need to get tickets to Essence Fest because Beyonce just released a preview for her new Miss Carter tour, and I don't want
to
miss it.
And we were supposed to show you that video, but I forgot to drop it in the box.
You
so we're gonna skip that and toss it straight to Marlon.
Welcome back to A Moment with Marlon, or as I must say, A Moment with Myself, and I am beyond excited for that body party video. I mean, Lord, Ciara just, the way it, oh. But yeah, like I was saying, Courtland, I wouldn't mind if I caught you having a little body party of your own. I think that'll be real cool. Me, you, at me on Christian Mingle. But anyway. Body Party was a successful video, and I must say it had not only the male viewers, but also the female viewers excited about it. And I must say this tangent of females, as in Beyonce and Ciara and Rihanna, they kind of been circling in the news lately. Beyonce dropped her little new H&M clothing line. Ciara drops Body Party. And what does Rihanna do? Rihanna decides to drop $8,000 on a strip at the King of Diamonds. Talking about she wanted to go ahead and pull it up. I said, babe, if you decide to pull it up, I got tuition I need to pay. And if that's the case, production, go ahead and switch it up for me.
Money on my mind, money on my mind. Throw it up, watch it fall off from the sky. Throw it up, watch it all fall out. Pull it up, that's how we ball out.
Welcome back, Hotspot. Viewers, first off, we have Bria Turner here with us again, like we do every week.
Yes, yes.
And guess what, people? It's the NBA playoffs, one of the most exciting times of the year. If you count the draft is pretty exciting too, but that's tomorrow. Today, we're still talking about NBA playoffs. Bria, are you excited?
Not really. Not as excited as I thought it was going to be. There's been, the only exciting matchup has been with Seth Curry. That's like Seth Curry. That's the only thing, exciting thing. Everything else has kind of been like, it's like the best versus the worst. It's kind
of
like.
Well, it is the first round of the playoffs, so I guess that's probably why. But a big game tonight is San Antonio versus the Los Angeles Lakers. And now we know that the Los Angeles Lakers are without Kobe Bryant, but in spirit, Kobe has kind of been in the game or at the game because he's been very active on Twitter, causing a lot of controversy. Not really controversy, but it's been making a lot of noise.
A lot of comments, and then it caused Mike D'Antoni to call him a fan.
What?
Yeah.
Mike D'Antoni.
A fan.
Mike D'Antoni. Kobe Bryant, a fan. Let's think about it. Kobe has 5 rings. Mike D'Antoni, how many rings do you have?
Kobe is the reason Mike D'Antoni still has a job, too, and for next year. But, you know.
I honestly don't see him lasting the next year. Because if you think about it, you might as well pay another coach and just keep Mike D'Antoni on your payroll because it's Kobe or D'Antoni. Even though Kobe's only going to have 2 or 3 more seasons, you probably can have 5 to 7 if you wanted to, I'll take that with a happy Kobe over a disgruntled Kobe and Mike D'Antoni.
The Lakers make more money off of 3 years of Kobe and any amount of years of D'Antoni, but, you know.
Because if I recall, when D'Antoni was in Phoenix, who was the guy who kept putting them out of the playoffs?
Okay, so next, in other news, Derrick Rose hyped us up for a return, and he did not return. Check this video out of him getting us excited.
Holding onto his knee and down.
he's been warming up with his teammates and playing against them, but he doesn't want to play a game.
Yeah,
I really don't know.
I've seen footage of it, and I'm like, okay, you're doing this. You look good on the court. Like, come back, Derrick Rose. We need you.
The
basketball.
People miss you.
We do. Like, Derrick Rose is one of the nicest players. He lives, eats, sleeps, and breathes basketball. And like a lot of analysts have been saying, it's really a mind thing with him. Like, he's healthy. He's been clear for months. And it's funny because Iman Shumpert had the same injury around the same time, and he's been back for months now. And it's just, we know Derrick Rose, you're young, you want to come back 100%, but the fans want you out there, man. So get in the game.
The streets need you, man. Okay, so lastly, we need to talk about Mike Brown going back to the Cavs after, what's it been, like, I don't even know how long it's been.
It's been like a season or two, but yeah. If you think about it, to me, Mike Brown is really racking in the money. He's still owed $8 million with the Los Angeles Lakers.
$8 million.
And he got a 20-year deal for 5 years with the Cavs. But my thing is, if you were going to hire Mike Brown again, why would you fire him in the first place?
I don't know. Well, I don't know. Just think the Cavs.
If you can describe that in one word, what would you say?
Stupid.
Stupid. Hop. There you go. See y'all after the break. Before I leave the set and let these two ladies enjoy their segment, I just had to say, and Corlin probably can't agree. Kendra, what's up with you?
I don't know.
Like, she's been full of energy, special energy and excitement today.
I love my job. No, that ain't what it is.
You know what that is?
She probably got chose.
Kendra got that glow, like I just put a picture of me and my man on Instagram glow. That's what that is. I would not know what that glow is like.
But hey, we're going to let y'all get back to girl talk. But Kendra, somebody's pretty excited.
Button your shirt.
Okay, well, welcome back. You are now tuned into Girl Talk with me, Kendra Turley, and the lovely Miss Cortland Johnson.
And girls, we do need to talk.
Okay, Cortland and I are worried that some of y'all are taking these trends just a little bit too far.
Yes, like, we need to do an intervention, like, please, let's
right
help
here,
the ladies.
Right now, this
right
issue
here, right now.
Needs to be addressed.
Yes. Please, let's go.
Okay, so first of all, the pointy nails. Okay, they were hot for a minute. I agree, but now some of y'all are just taking them way too far. Like literally too far. The nails are like reaching from here to the moon. Like, come on now.
Yes, because like I saw a girl the other day. Like she was tweeting that she cut herself while she was putting on her shoes because her nails are so pointy.
Shame. Okay, tell them what number two is, Court.
Okay, number two, we have. Black and white.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is black and white. I go online to do a little online shopping. All I see is black and white. Can I have a little bit color? Little color in my life? Like, I can't. What a color at?
I know, and it's almost summer, too, so I don't know why everybody would want to be. I mean, don't get me wrong. I love black and white, but it's summer. I want to be in,
everybody
orange,
looking like
blue,
Beetlejuice.
Green.
Like, I can't.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Cortland.
Right.
Okay, number three, leggings. These leggings. Oh, my goodness. First of all, leggings are not for everybody. Second of all, leggings do not go with everything. And third of all, some of these patterns look like they belong on someone's kitchen table, not on your legs.
Especially, let me just speak to the plus size ladies. Baby, if your leggings, the pattern on your leggings look like something on your grandmama's kitchen table, it's not for you. You have a wide load. You can't spread it across. You know, like when it starts looking white, that's how you know it's too much.
Don't do it. Okay, number four, tell them what it is.
Last one, ombre hair. Okay, I'm kind of feeling this trend a little bit, but that picture up top on the left with Sierra, that looked like, baby, you just got black roots and you just let them grow out.
Ooh, yeah, I think Nicki Minaj was the only one who could kind of pull off the crazy ombre hair, but other than that, No. Okay, well, we hope that we stopped some of y'all from these trends, but, we're just trying to help y'all out. We didn't mean to offend anyone, but...
Just a little innovation.
Yeah,
just a little innovation.
Overkill.
What you want, Myron? What you want?
One more thing. While we at it, ladies, and I'm sure they can agree, ladies...
Girl, talk.
I'm sorry, but I had to mention, ladies, y'all got to stop wearing these crosses on your ears.
Ooh.
Gotta stop.
Yeah,
it. I enjoy you dancing in a club, but I don't need to see you...
I don't need to see your Jesus
popping
pieces
it for pimp
on your
Jesus.
Ears.
No. He died for us.
Don't wear it to the club.
Yeah,
don't wear it.
See Jesus.
I saw one girl, she had crosses on this big, but she didn't come up for air. At bounce night, at Shady.
All right, we're going to leave it at that. Okay, that's all the time we have for Girl Talk, but we will see you guys after the break.
Bye, ladies.
Welcome back, Hot Spotters. Let's give you a little recap of what happened today. Make sure you go on YouTube and watch what?
Chanel's new video, Savage.
Type in Nelly and Savage, and it should pop up. Number two, ladies, oh, man, just saying, your body should be your party. Am I right?
No.
Uh-huh. One thing we ought to mention from last week, We didn't put it on. We didn't put it on the show. And Kendra's back in. And she's making noise. We didn't put it on the show, but Sweet Brown's cold popping video dropped.
Yes.
And you got to go check it out.
The whole thing takes place like right in the hood, like right in the center of the project. She's just trying to get a cold pop. That's the whole video.
And honestly, you ain't got time for that. Don't watch.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
But it is funny. And lastly, next week is unfortunately the last show of the season.
The last show.
But it's going to be one to remember. So, hope y'all have a great day. Study for your tests and
good luck on finals.
Yeah. See y'all later.
Bye.